sure, Doctor?
Well, I'm at the first clear branching of these structures, such as reported by Dr. Gorski.
All right. What happened next?
I confirm. It's the fourth one. I see our flag. I'm afraid I won't find him for a while. It's hard to see if these traces are fresh. This place is quite sheltered from the wind, so it could well have been hours since he left.
No more than six, considering the time frame we have. Take comfort in the fact that on a cosmic scale, it is nothing.
Huh. Very comforting. He followed the branch to the right. Another thing he reported was a massive vertical structure. I should move. Oh, there's no time. I'm still here, if you're wondering, sir. It all just takes longer than expected.
I know the situation. No need to explain yourself, Doctor. We're in this together. Status?
Nothing's changed, Astrogator.
Understood.
structures undergo noticeable changes here. If it keeps growing at this rate, I don't know what I'll find at the end.
What kind of growth are you talking about, Doctor? Depth, width, complexity level?
In every aspect.
Interesting. Do you think these veins lead somewhere? To something?
I'm leaning more and more towards that conclusion. But I can't tell what we might expect at the end, if it ends at all. Is departing.
Yes, they're on their way. Thank you for your assistance. Without your help, it would have taken much longer.
What's the plan for the second flight? The same place?
That would work better. Certain, proven. When you and Dr. Gorski come back, I'll send the lander right away.
The top. The doctor discovered something new from here. Something he called bushes.
Huh. I've heard that term before.
In their conversations between Kovel and Gorski.
No, Jasna. You're the one who reported it to me. Right after you landed.
Seriously? Well, I don't see anything like it now, sir. Wait. Kovel noted down the parameters. Azimuth 350. Distance 200 meters.
Copy that. I'm sending the probe.
Got it. I see the bushes.
And the doctor?
Hard to tell. Visibility is poor. It's going to be harder than before. I don't know how the doctor...
But when it comes to finding a safe route, there won't be a problem. But you'll have to get there on your own 2 feet.
I suppose a probe will carry out the first task. It's capable yet?
Of course. I set the environment analysis mode. The probe will calculate the best route between your location and your destination. It'll guide you along the defined path. The calculations will only take a moment.
Olga, lead the way. I must say, it's a clever device, this probe of ours. Hey, can it fly for this long?
Yes. Longer than you can stand on your feet.
Sounds like the perfect research unit. Maybe even better than a human.
Well, let's not exaggerate.
Of course, I wasn't being serious. However helpful they may be, they're still just tools in the hand of man, often faulty.
something serious?
I already mentioned the faulty machines, right? Well, the route determined by the algorithm goes over a chasm.
I can repeat the command.
No. I'll go around.
Unfortunately, this is an outdated model. Such mistakes are inevitable. But the perception module itself has already been greatly improved. Its accuracy increases exponentially.
Exponentially? Can you imagine us, protonaceous creatures, developing so quickly, sir?
No, not in the course of evolution. You can't perfect a person like that.
That's right, you can't. We wait thousands of years for visible changes.
Have you started to fear for your position?
Well, everything indicates that the clear distinction between humans and robots will soon disappear.
And then what?
Well, if we assume that they'll surpass us, things will get complicated. Because in order to program a brain with computing power equal to that of a human, you need a brain with computing power higher than that of a human. Ergo, a man cannot make a machine smarter than a man.
Then who else would design it?
The self-learning algorithms? Some spontaneous process? Or pure chaos? Something inhuman, that's for sure. These bushes are kind of weird.
You better stay away, Doctor. I'd like a brief description. Just keep a distance.
Allow me to use the language I would use to describe living forms, sir.
Of course.
So they look like pituitary, brush-like formations. They're high, more or less, from 1 to several meters. They grow out of cracks in the bare rock. They can be singular, though in some locations they create a uniform thicket that covers the walls of the ravine in a rusty brush-like layer. That's how it looks, to put it briefly.
Would you also venture to guess their significance? Some function, purpose?
Staying on the topic of biological analogy, which in itself is already a major scientific distortion.
Yes, I understand. These are not real plants.
But if they were plants, those protruding parts climbing up, they would serve to obtain energy, mainly solar. Astrogator, Gorski's not here. I'm afraid he continued to explore. And if he went where I think he did, he might have lost contact with the camp as well as Dragonfly. Possibly. Well, there's only one way to be certain. It's your decision, sir.
Please continue your search. We have to find it.
That's the unwritten rule.
The
line's breaking up, but I understood. I'll let you know, sir, when I come out of the tunnel.
Altitude 24,000, speed 295.
Can you hear me?
Loud and clear. Any side effects? Landing wasn't too hard on you?
All good. Spine still in one piece. No signs of overstrain. Not even shortness of breath.
Perfect. Hopefully the hike to camp goes just as smoothly.
The dust has already settled. I've located the second lander. Our people are still... Sir, something's wrong.
What is it?
The hatch is half open. Did they report hydraulics failure?
How should I know? You were the last person in contact with the crew, Doctor.
Right. I'm inside.
And? How is it?
Even if they wanted to, they couldn't go back to Dragonfly. Their lander looks damaged, to put it mildly. Or more accurately, it seems like a storm has passed through it.
Understood. I mean, I don't understand how it happened. But that means...
Hopper is the only vehicle that can take us home. Affirmative.
Right. But then we can't afford another mistake. I'm taking the lander into orbit. I'll send it directly to the camp as soon as we find a suitable landing zone.
We've gotten out of worse than this. Equipment breaks from time to time, that's normal. But now...
Go ahead. What's bothering you?
This lack of communication. It takes too long. Especially considering there's a cyberneticist amongst them.
Yes. It worries me too.
You were right, Cobble. It's beautiful here. I have an object in sight. This is where they searched the ocean's biocenosis.
Meaning, where they call that fish, right?
Yeah. They stopped here first, then walked along the coastline northward.
Correct. But I think you might consider taking a shortcut towards the east, straight to the camp.
Just need to find the right route.
Signs of the crew?
I found a cigarette butt and a pack. Someone was smoking here.
So, they didn't give a damn about the regulations.
Disrupting the ecosystem.
That's not the point. I understand you want to minimize the effects of our interference here, Doctor, but the mission's safety is at stake. I only now to explain to you the dangers of igniting a dusty atmosphere. Preserving the integrity of Regis 3's already extinct ecosystem is not a priority in this scenario. Negligible, actually.
Security procedures exist for humans. The rule of integrity is for the sake of everything alien to us. We shouldn't place one above the other.
You say, yes, sir. The mission and the safety of our people have the highest priority. Always.
Always? Are we really that self-righteous?
Of course, Doctor. We must be the most important to ourselves. And they must be the most important to themselves, whoever they will be.
Excuse my interruption, sir. Can you please confirm that I'm on the correct route?
Yes, I confirm. This route will reach the camp within an hour. So, continuing. Isn't that how evolution works?
Not in a biological sense, Astrogator. Besides, I'm not convinced if we should interfere with everything alien to us just because we can.
Doctor, interference is at the heart of human nature. Man would still be a monkey if he'd only looked at trees instead of cutting them down.
Yeah. This road may be faster, but it's not the easiest. Anyway, back to our conversation. I can't argue with that. Structure. It looks like some spiky metal growths.
Artificial plants? Is spontaneous growth possible with this type of structure?
I've never seen anything like this. I wish I had time to run some tests.
When the situation is stabilized, we will take samples. I promise.
Oh. I feel nauseous. Suddenly. That's not it. I feel darkness. Are you there? Over. I guess that's a no.
I'm back.
Is everything all right?
Yes, all good. They're already in the
about their reactions? Have they regained consciousness? I mean, maybe one of them said something.
Yeah, unfortunately, they're still unresponsive. I'll let you know if anything changes. I'm doing an EEG on them right now.
I confirm. Gorski was here. His rope is still hanging from the slope.
That's a good sign. Since he left it, he intends to come back this way.
Why hasn't he yet? I'm going down after him. Tell me one more thing. When it comes to Marit, are you going to use a grave tapper? Not at all.
What do you mean?
I'm stuck. I'm hanging with all my weight on the rope, away from the wall. There's still a fair few meters left to the ground.
Can you go back?
Using just my hands, strapped with all this extra weight? No, not a chance.
What if you swim?
No good. I can't reach anything.
Any other ideas?
I can just jump off.
Is that safe?
I think it is.
You think? You shouldn't base your safety on assumptions. Situation carefully.
I'm thinking, if Gorski went down this way and didn't break anything.
Yeah, we don't know that, Yasna. He could keep going even with injuries.
Okay, this is a waste of time. You only die once. Here we go.
What's happening? Did you fall?
I jumped.
Status, please. Can you walk?
Yes. No fractures.
Please stop for a moment. Make sure you're all right.
No, there's no need for a delay. Dr. Gorski is waiting. Is amazing. It's all made up of these structures, except they don't look like creations of nature anymore.
Maybe that's why Dr. Gorski, not to mention the Alliance.
Well, if we're looking for something on this planet, this could be it. These structures form entire multi-story complexes. They look like a city.
Yeah. Are you saying that...
No, no. There's no point in jumping to conclusions yet. Oh, shit. The telemeter glass cracked.
I wouldn't worry. What matters is that you're fine.
Anyway, Dr. Gorski set up the flags.
Sir, he kept going, despite the lack of communication with the rest.
You'd have to see it with your own eyes, sir. This place. Gorski may have lost himself in his discovery.
Are you joking, Doctor? Lost himself? Gorski? He may not have respect for the unknown, but he has his feet firmly on the ground. Should be looking for a way back by now.
I think he must have discovered something. And since he suffers from excessive ambition, he's capable of stupid acts in the name of a breakthrough.
Well, I admit, that sounds more like him. You must trace his steps, Doctor.
I'm working on it. Are you receiving a signal?
What signal?
From Dr. Gorski.
No, no. Why are you asking?
He tried to open up a connection, set up a transmitter.
There's nothing on the comms. But I'll check the record history. Please give me a moment.
See the bottom.
The structures go that deep?
Yes. I dread to think. What if Dr. Gorski fell down there?
I took that into account when calibrating the probe. It will examine the bottom. I'll let you know if I find him.
The height of the entire complex is over 100 meters. Even 150.
And all made of this metal?
To a significant degree. Is something were to live here?
Yes.
It would have to be very small. Like insects. On the other hand, there's no floor around to support such organisms.
The terrain, those structures, are they still everywhere?
Yep, wherever I look, there's metal. We've gone over everything in that area. I see the probe. Has it found anything interesting?
The thermal scan lights up at your position. Other than that, it's won't be ruin. Everything's cold, dead, very old.
It's a bit like Pando.
In what? I have no idea what you're talking about, Doctor.
A colony of populous tremoloids. American aspen. The new trees grow not from seeds, but from root suckers of old trees. As a result, it's one giant organism, thousands of years old.
So you're in a dead metal forest?
That does sound bizarre. So maybe.
Doctor, something has been recorded after all. But there are plenty of errors in the transmission header. It's hard to say whether this is a message from Gorski.
Well then, sir, play it. Maybe we'll finally find out what's going on with the Doctor. Traces, this time handprints, and a drop detector.
What? Did I hear you right?
Yes, sir, you heard correctly. I'm afraid we must be ready for any eventuality.
Yeah, well, that doesn't mean we should assume the worst. I still believe you'll find him, Doctor. Maybe let's go back to the recording.
Something. No one of sound mind would decide to go down this way. And yet, Gorski.
Well, let's hear what else you discovered.
Okay. Moving on.
Reading us. Well, that's it. What follows is just a humming noise. Any thoughts, Doctor?
So far, it all leads to one conclusion. This is not a place for a man. Nor for any humanoid. Ouch!
Yes, now what is it?
I took a shortcut.
On purpose?
Not really. This is not a place for a man. Nor for any humanoids.
Then who is it for?
Maybe it's really an alien technology. Those Lyrans.
As far as I know, all information about the Lyran civilization is just guesswork. Many consider Lyrans to be just a myth, so I wouldn't take it too seriously.
Well, I think there might be something to it.
By the way, you were right, Doctor. Gorski did lose himself in this discovery, in spite of everything.
Finally, I have his position.
A visual?
Not yet. Gorski, are you here? It's me, Jasna.
Still not?
Yeah. I found his backpack. You know what that means, sir?
Yes, he's without oxygen. We must hurry.
Almost there. Oh, there he is. Got him. He's not moving. Gorski, look at me. His eyes are closed.
Is he breathing?
He's alive, but barely.
Did he react in any way?
No reaction. He seems unconscious. Gorski, come on.
Calm down, Doctor. Get him out of there. The probe's already looking for a landing site.
He's out. I activated his SOS. You should pick up a transmission with his parameters, sir. Well?
No, nothing. The transmitter in the suit must be too weak.
Should I retrieve his booster from the backpack?
No point. Better to set up a relay. We have to do it anyway so that Hopper can land in this maze. Have a preliminary scan of your surroundings. There's an open area nearby. You have to move Gorski there. The probe will guide you.
But he's not stable. I must share my oxygen with him, Astrogator.
You'd need a spare for that. The protocol doesn't provide for connecting two suits at the same time.
In that case, I'll give him my tank.
Negative. I won't allow it, Yasna. If you faint, the doctor won't carry you.
The membrane looks intact.
What did you tell me? I didn't hear.
Hold on, Gorski.
I still can't hear you, Doctor. Please repeat.
It's nothing, Astrogator. Some static on the line.
Are you out in the open already?
Sort of. Yes.
Once you've set up the transmitter, I should...